Yo, what's crackin', boys? It's me, Daily Tactics, here back with some more Men of War Assault Squad 2, the Star Wars Galaxy at War mod. And I don't know why this is, but very often I get requested to do the Battle of Felucia. It's really weird. I do it a bunch on my channel. We've done it in Rico's Brigade, we've done it in Daily Squad, we've done just regular battles of Felucia, but I keep getting requests for it. I don't know what it is about this battle. Maybe it's the quirky trees, maybe it's because it resembles Nam, and you know, when the trees start speaking binary, the droids come out. Who knows why Felucia is so popular, but it is. So I thought, you know what? I've gotten a lot of requests recently to do it. Let's roll it back and do it again. There is no Rico's Brigade this week because I'm working on the stop motion, which should be coming out on June 1st. So I need the time I normally allocate to Rico's Brigade for that. I hope you understand, but I hope that doing a highly requested video will make up for it at least a little bit. I know people love Rico's Brigade, but I just gotta take a brief break this week from it. Either way, we have just a full-scale battle of Felucia. We have literally hundreds, if not thousands, of clone troopers here. We have ATTEs, we have OPs, I believe these are called, with clones lining them in those troop transports. We've got ground infantry troopers. We have TX-130Ts. We have UT-ATs in the hills here. The clone army is just absolutely massive and absolutely booming in this battle. And the same goes for the droid army. So the droids have these homing droids. They have MTTs, they have dwarf spider droids, they have AMTs, they have AAT tanks, and then they have a ton of these troop carriers as well. So both sides are totally kitted out for an awesome battle in this really large trench filled Felucia space here. It should be really, really sick and really, really cool. So without further ado, guys, we'll get this thing going. If you enjoy the video, please hit that like button. Let's try and get 2,000 likes in the first 24 hours. Subscribe if you haven't already. At 200k, we're going to be doing a huge Lego giveaway, so you'll want to be subbed for that. And comment down below what your favorite battle in the Clone Wars is, and if you want me to do it. If we have already done it, we can do it again, or if we haven't done it, new content, baby. Either way, without further ado, let's get it popping. Alrighty then, fellas, let's go ahead and press start right now, and both armies should begin marching forward. Since this is so large scale, it might be a little bit laggy, and we might go into slow-mo because there's some weird thing where going into slow-mo helps in terms of lag. So maybe we'll end up doing that if it is really, really bad. Either way, the faster vehicles are in the front here. The TX-130Ts as well as the UT-ATs are out here. Meanwhile, the droids have a similar thing going on, I suppose. And these TX-130Ts tend to sort of be recon vehicles anyway, so they're the first up in the battlefield here, and they are getting peppered by tons and tons of droid fire. Looks like they do manage to take out a super battle droid right off the bat there, but they are getting hit really, really hard. This one's sirens are already being activated. I imagine these things will go down extraordinarily quickly. Yep, there goes one of the TX-130Ts, and the other one follows suit soon after. One in the very front here still managing to stay alive, manages to take out an AMT right there. Meanwhile, further back, the ATTEs and ATOTs are now dropping off their troopers and beginning to get some fire out themselves. The clone infantry troopers on the ground are also beginning to fire out, managing to get some good shots on these super battle droids. They're watching those wrist rockets and managing to take them out. Very, very well done. The poor lads who died very, very early into the battle before they even managed to probably get a shot off. I feel bad for those fellas. It's rough. It's rough. One of the homing droids does blow up right there, and these MTTs are taking some pretty serious flak at the moment. I imagine they dropped off their infantry and they must have skedaddled like this way or something like that. Here's a bunch of infantry. I don't even know where the droid infantry is. They kind of blend in with the ground. Oh, there's a whole bunch right here on this lakeside with a homing droid. Over here, the super tank is beginning to march on forward here. This thing is a force to be reckoned with. It has the Nebelwerfer built in, which can just absolutely decimate clone infantry units, and also tanks. If those things get some direct hits on tanks, they can be seriously, seriously devastating. We also have droidikas with their shields up, firing at the clone trooper infantry off in the distance. Those things can definitely be taken out pretty easily by clone infantry with bazookas, but, you know, it's risky. You gotta get pretty close in order to do it, and, you know, usually the droidikas are surrounded by some droid infantry as well. So it's a tough nut to crack, those droidicas, but it certainly can be done. Especially with the backup of these ATTEs, which are certainly helping right now. Look at this. This is pretty sick. A little canyon battle. The clones doing most of the pushing and playing very, very aggressively against the droids. Meanwhile, the droids are just sort of sitting in wait and getting plenty of shots off themselves at the oncoming clone trooper units. It's almost as if the infantry here is non-essential. They are just here to be cannon fodder. They're just adding extra units to the battle. This is truly a battle of tanks. It's tanks grinding it out, trying to kill each other, trying to get the right shots on the shields and wiping them out. Meanwhile, the infantry is just there. It's just chilling. It's not exactly doing all that much. Here we've got some droids in the trees up here, actually firing at the UTATs. So, I mean, they're doing some damage to the tanks, but the clone infantry is trying to wipe them out. Both sides taking some losses here, neither side coming out on top quite yet. It does look like the clones might outnumber the droids in this particular instance over here, but we'll just have to wait and see who manages to be the victor. Actually, a dwarf spider coming around the bend here. These things can be very, very devastating, especially against infantry, but the UT-AT does manage to land a nice little shot on it, point blank, exploding it into oblivion. That thing is gone, done, and dusted. The super tank here is still alive. Oh, ATTE going down. That is very bad for the clones. ATTEs are, of course, their most powerful tank in the game. And it just gets absolutely scrapped right there. So not a good look for the clone troopers. A bunch of dead AATs over here, though. Oh, a TX-130T is actually still alive. It looks like that one didn't kamikaze forward in the very beginning of the battle. So that's a good sign for the clones. Is it the TX-130Ts that sirens are going off, or is it the super tank? I genuinely cannot tell. MTTs also still managing to stay alive. This battle has turned into just a tank graveyard mess. Oh, I think the super tank went down. Oh, that's a big dubski right there for the clone trooper units. No more Nebelwerfer for the droids. Let's check in on the far left over here, because we really haven't observed over this way. Looks like there is a TX-130T still alive way out here, which is surprising. There's a troop transport, and then there's a bunch of clones amongst the bunkers over here, but, I mean, there's barely any droid infantry, and really, the clones don't even have that big of a presence over here. This UT-AT is just stuck. How odd. The left side of the battlefield is really, like, got not a lot going on. Meanwhile, the right and the middle is just an absolute tear-it-apart war zone with tons of action going on, so kind of peculiar how certain parts of the battlefield just don't get, you know, interacted with nearly as much. It is still just an absolute cluster over here, though. Both sides not really making much progress against the others. Every once in a while, a vehicle goes down for one side or the other, but all in all, it is just still an explosion fest. You know, the shields on some of these tanks are still managing to hold out, and that's what's keeping them alive. But once the shields go down, that's basically when you know that the rest of the tank will go down very soon after as well. Is this ATTE dead? No, it's still alive, actually. Huh. I think its top cannon doesn't have a gunner, and it doesn't really seem like its front cannons are doing anything, so maybe it's just completely out of action. That could be the problem there, you know? Oh, UT-AT making a few power plays. There goes the ATTE, which makes the UT-ATs the most powerful tanks on the ground floor for the clone troopers at the moment. They've still got AT-OTs back here, and these things do have front cannons, but they are pretty crummy. They don't do a lot, so, you know, it'll take a lot of shots from the AT-OT cannon in order to actually get any kills for the clone trooper army. This droidica back here is actually on fire right now. It seems like its shield is still holding up slightly, but it's taken some serious hits, and the interior somehow took a little bit of damage. Maybe the clones rolled some explosives in there. Ooh! It's airborne! It's up there! ATTE getting some air, baby! This UT-AT up here is on fire. Usually alludes to the fact that its shield is down. A lot of things are on fire currently. A lot. There's a lot on fire. There's still a homing droid way back here with a whole bunch of droid infantry, and it seems to just sort of be stuck amongst the trees in Felucia. Those are some hard trees. The trees on Felucia, made of cement. Very powerful and very nice. A bunch of clone infantry has sort of come out of the woodwork here. They must have propelled themselves forward a little bit after the major tank battle sort of seceded and came to a close. Now it's sort of, the scraps of infantry and the last remaining, tanks, which are heavily damaged, sort of fighting it out amongst each other. I think it's still either side's game because the droids still have a whole bunch of infantry back here and a homing droid and, some AMT tanks and a few AAT tanks. Meanwhile, the clones have definitely more infantry but less tanks. They've got a few of these AT-OTs left alive. They got one UT-AT that is, pretty damaged. And then I think there's a TX-130T still somewhere. No, that one back there ended up dying. Maybe there is no TX-130T. Interesting. So yeah, I would say the clones are definitely superior right now in terms of infantry, which is a weird thing to say because normally the Republic is at a extreme infantry deficit, but not in this case. Not in this case. If we actually look at the minimap right now, blue are Republic units left alive, red are the droid units. You can see at the top left up there. And I have to say the droids definitely have more tanks, but way, way less infantry. So that is pretty interesting. None of the clones over here have a bazooka. There are clone troopers with bazookas, but it is a real shame that none of them are right here to help out against this AMT tank, which is just shredding clone troopers bit by bit. Oh god, the UT-AT. It's airborne, baby. Oh, if it lands flat, it'll be okay. Oh, no, AT-TEY. Oh, it's still alive. Okay, if a tank ends up on its backside and turtles, then the tank is done for, essentially, in this game. It'll automatically out the crew and then activate the self-destruct mode. So you really need your tanks to land on their feet if they do go, airborne like that. Is this AMT back here still alive? No, that thing is on fire and shredded. Done and dusted, baby. That thing ain't coming back anytime soon. All right. Are these MTTs still alive? Okay, this one is, but this one is as well, actually. Okay, both MTTs alive. These things are, of course, not very powerful in terms of weaponry, but they've got one heck of a piece of armor on them that can, outlast a ton of shots coming in at them. The little pocket of droid infantry over here is almost dead. Let's move the homing droid out because it's just stuck and it's trapping all of the droid infantry in. So we'll release that. Are there any clone tanks we can release from the grips of trees? Oh, there's this UT-AT over here. Okay. So okay, both sides get one tank allowed to be moved out into the open. That's the rule there, because it was getting frustrating watching them struggle in the trees. It's a struggle bus, boys. Either way, a lot of the clone infantry is getting shredded by the last remaining droid tanks. This AMT in particular is just one-shotting them bit by bit. How many kills does it have? 30 kills! That is very impressive. And of course, it's destroying the bodies, leaving just the helmets. Oh, I hate that. Doesn't give us a good representation at the end of the battle of how many troopers each side had. It's really tragic. More clone infantry coming in. Oh, they managed to take out an AAT. That's, that's a pretty big kill right there. This AMT is apparently still alive. No, it's actually the droidica that's still alive. This thing is dead. I thought on the main map it looked like it was this thing. But no, it's the droidica is still alive right there. Very interesting. There's actually a ton of clone infantry still alive over here as well. Huh. And this UT-AT is navigating the trees once more. Oh my god, how is the homing droid doing? Homing droid's doing better than the UT-AT. It's at least progressing forward a little bit here. And it's got some infantry behind it too. So maybe this thing will get into some action and help out. Does the AMT up here even need help? It is just shredding clone trooper after clone trooper, having 30 plus kills. It's pretty impressive. There's actually a whole squad of clones way back here too. Oh, and an AAT's back here. What? it's such a large battle that there's all these units just randomly in crazy places, like that you'd never expect them to be. It's like, how did you get there? Why are you there? Please leave, sir. It's kind of crazy. And now the AMT is trying to shred this AT-OT. AT-OT, it's got pretty powerful armor, to be honest. And it'll take a lot of AMT shots to actually shred that thing. The clone infantry is still sort of progressing forward a little bit here, getting some grenades out. That might have been meant for the droidica, but it bounced weird or something like that. I see dead droid infantry over there, but I think those guys were long dead, so I don't know about that. The AT-OT over there is trying to take some pot shots at this droidica, but the droidica is actually kind of protected by the AMT tank, which is crazy. It's kind of funny. Homing droid over here got itself stuck again. I mean, the battle's kind of descending into chaos, you know? I'm not even sure if this thing can destroy this AT-OT. Or is it an AT-AP? Have I been pronouncing this thing wrong the whole time? Last time I pronounced said the wrong tank name, people just shredded me in the comments. Like, the other day in the Super Fortress video. Actually, that was yesterday. That's an AT-AT. No, it is an AT-OT. Thank goodness. Oh my god. Last time in the first order Super Fortress video, I kept calling the AT-AT an AAT, which I obviously know the difference. I just kept pronouncing it wrong. You know, it's a simple mistake. Yet the comments, man, it's as if like I you know, made a Yamada joke or something, or insulted their very being. They were like, "This is so infuriating. I can't believe." I was like, "Oh my god, guys, chill." You know, sometimes you just can't read the comments, man. So sometimes they're a bit much, you know, and I love you guys, but my goodness, guys, the simplest mistake and I get roasted like it's, you know, like I committed a war crime. It can be pretty bad, fellas. It can be pretty bad. But luckily, I have been pronouncing the AT-OT correctly, which is very good. Very nice, very cool. Well, I don't really see this battle going anywhere for the rest of this thing. I mean, it's just kind of a mess. It's like tanks that are never going to die, and then infantry that aren't really doing anything. Let's try going into fast speed for a little bit here. Oh, we've actually got, like, 3 droid infantry charged over there. There's actually a good amount of droid infantry over this way. Interesting. And the UT-AT is now on top of this hill over there. It's kind of interesting. This droidica is still cheesing it right there. The homing droid comes free and now starts moving forward a little bit. Oh, look. We actually got some action that we can watch. Okay, here we go. So the UT-AT and the homing droid have finally connected on the battlefield. The two dumbest tanks who kept getting stuck finally unstuck. And finally, the Battle of the Titans commences. We'll see if either side manages to actually win this thing. This thing is like double teaming. Like, half of it is attacking the UT-AT and half of it is attacking the AT-OTs over there. Meanwhile, an AMT tank coming around the back to flank the UT-AT. There's a lot going on. There's a lot of moving parts here, fellas. There's a lot of moving parts. This is a wild and crazy battle. Gotta admit it. This is very interesting. It's like a Mexican standoff that went hot, and now it's like every side is blasting each other in some way. The AT-OT is blasting the AMT. AMT is blasting the AT-OT. Homing droid is blasting both the UT-AT and the AT-OT. The UT-AT is blasting the homing droid and the MTT. And then the droidica's just in there too, and a bunch of clone infantry. It's just like a round robin. With no sides dying. Oh, AMT died over there. Oh, finally, another vehicle dies after, like, ages. After absolute ages here. Well, let's see what happens. There's still some action. We got action, boys. We got action. Oh, there's actually droid infantry back there. Where's the clone infantry? Send some clone infantry in here. We know we got them. The clones have, like, all the infantry in the world. Let's see, most of the clone infantry is, like, over here. Yeah, there's a whole stack of Phase 2 clones over that way. I don't know why I didn't use the 327th for this. I guess I was just kind of like, I just use standard clones. I didn't really think about it. Weird. I mean, the 327th are, of course, kind of synonymous with the Battle of Felucia, so I don't really see why it didn't, but I don't know. Brain fart. Oh, well. C'est la vie, man. C'est la vie, indeed. What can you do? What can you do? Either way, guys, people wanted an update on the stop motion, and it is coming together. It is coming together pretty well. You know, I don't want to give anything away, but I should be able to meet that June 1st deadline that I set for myself. I really hope I can. After this video is released, I'm spending a few hours setting up the final few scenes here and recording them, and then the lengthiest part, I would say, is probably the editing, getting all the effects in there and making it the way I want it to be and stuff like that. But, like, you know, the way I've been doing it is just one scene at a time. You know, I don't leave anything for the very end. I shoot a scene, I edit that scene, I produce the scene, it's all good, then I move on, then I shoot the next one, you know. I know a lot of people shoot everything all at once and then edit it all, but I like the satisfaction of getting a scene done, you know, and being able to say, okay, this is it, this is the scene now. Okay, this battle has descended into chaos. Let's go in fast speed, see if anything develops here, I guess, for a minute or two, and then if nothing develops, we can call it a draw. Okay, homing droid dies. Alright. Droidica's still alive there. I mean, both sides still have tanks. You gotta remember, these MTTs are technically alive. Oh god, UT-AT. Don't die. Yeah, I mean, it's just kind of chaos here. UT-AT is now having its fun on these droid infantry. There's really not a lot happening. I'd probably call this a Republic victory. They have more powerful tanks left alive, and they're sort of dominating the field. The droids just have sort of a bunch of derps alive, you know? This droidica did nothing the entire battle. It's just doing a little scuttle dance. Scuttle, 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 scuttle. And then they've got, like, some, like, there's a random homing droid back here that's stuck and not doing anything. There's a troop transport there. There's, like, a couple MTTs that haven't done anything in forever. And they have, like, no infantry. The clones have all the infantry. There's an AAT over here. I don't know, maybe it really is a draw. I think this is a draw, you know? Nothing's really happening here. I don't think anything will happen for the next, like, 30 minutes. So, yeah, I mean, there's nothing going on. Just sort of derps all around. So I think we're going to go ahead and call this battle a draw. Thank you guys so much for watching. Here's the death. You know, yellow are dead clones, red are dead droids, but I mean, literally almost all of the infantry bodies were destroyed in this battle, and also a lot of the tanks no longer appear, so you really get nothing from that. But there was a lot of destruction in this battle, and I thought it was really fun. I hope you guys enjoyed too. Thank you so much for watching. Comment down below what you thought. Subscribe if you haven't already. Like the video, and I'll see you all in the next one. Peace! I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Be sure to click that subscribe button for more content, and hit the notification bell if you'd like to be alerted to whenever I live stream or upload. Thanks so much.